Hi, this is Yusuf Beg, lecturer in mathematics, having more than 18 years plus experience. I am an instrumental hand in producing IIT JE mains and advanced ranks. Okay, now I am going to discuss definite integration. We'll discuss the definite integration. What is a definite integration and what are its properties? Okay, presently, now in this session, I am going to discuss what is the definite integration. Okay, what is the definite integration? We'll discuss clearly. Okay, so here see what is the definition of integration? What is the definition of definite integration? We'll discuss. Now see this here we know that indefinite integration. What is the indefinite integration? Integration of f of x dx is equal to the integration of small f of x dx is equal to the, it is capital F of x plus c, capital F of x plus c. So then this capital F of x we are called as, okay, it is a small f of x and this capital F of x, capital F of x we are called as the integration of small f of x, capital F of x we are called as the integration of small f of x, means it is the answer of the small f of x. Integration of small f of x answer is the capital F of x, mean that is capital F of x is a function in terms of x. You can observe it is a function in terms of x. So see, and this capital F of x is also called as the antiderivative, or we can call as primitive. We are called as primitive. Okay, it is primitive, or we can call it is as the, or we can call it is as the integration of small f of x. So capital F of x name is, capital F of x name is, what is the capital F of x? Capital F of x name is antiderivative or primitive or integration of small f of x. So this is the capital F of x. If you observe, it is capital F of x is a function in terms of x. So this function in terms of x will become a constant in definite integration. How it become a constant in definite integration? Now we can observe. Okay, now come to see. Okay, so this is if you observe, it is, so this capital F of x name we are given as, it is the antiderivative or primitive or integration of small f of x. Okay, so this capital F of x will become as the constant. Capital F of x will become as the constant. Capital F of x will become as the constant. Okay, capital F of x become as the constant. Now see, capital F of x at x equal to a. Okay, at x equal to a, what should be its answer? At x equal to a, this is the f of a plus c. Okay, at x equal to b, the answer of the integration at x equal to b, it will become as the f of b plus c. Okay, so if you observe these two answers, what is the difference of these two answers? Okay. Difference mean we are taking the difference is upper value minus lower value, otherwise the difference become the negative. Okay, so mean we have to take the upper value. What is the upper value? It is capital F of B plus C minus of capital F of A plus C. Okay, so that means what we can say here, cap here my plus C minus C cancel. Okay, what you got it here, f of b minus f of a. So this f of b minus f of a, so if you observe, it is f of b minus f of a, the answer you got it is independent of constant c. Okay, which is independent of constant c, we are not observing this c, so this c is gone. Okay, so this is independent of constant c, and this is a pure mathematical number. You substituted the some constant values a and b instead of x, that the function in terms of x become a constant. When you substitute the x is equal to a and x equal to b, it become a constant. Okay, so that is this is a mean constant minus constant. Constant minus constant is again a constant. So this is, it is a constant. So this is constant, or it is a pure mathematical number or numerical number or numerical number. So this is a pure mathematical number or numerical number. So this numerical number or constant, this purely mathematical number, we are called as, this is, we are called as the definite integration. This is the topic. Okay, so this definite integration meaning is, it is a constant. Definite integration answer is, definite integration answer is the, is a constant, mean it is a mathematical number. It is a pure mathematical number or a constant or a numerical number. Definite integration mean is a numerical number. Okay, so that is, it is a numerical number, f of b minus f of a. This is the definite integration. So now we will see how this is, we are getting this is by substituting, how we are getting this is c. This I am taking, it is a, so this I am going to take this one. Okay, if you observe, it is okay. So what it become as, it is the, so this is we can take it is c. It is integration of f of x dx is equal to the integration of f of x dx equal to the capital f of x plus c, capital f of x plus c. Okay, so this integration f of x dx is equal to capital f of x plus c. This is small f of x. So this is, we are called as the integrand. This is the primitive. Okay, if you are applying the limits, it is the integration, it is from the limits a to b. You are taking x is equal to a. X equal to a you are taken. X equal to b you are taken. So that is, at x equal to a, x is equal to a to x is equal to b. X is equal to a to x equal to b. The integration a to b, we have to read it as the integration a to b f of x dx is equal to the, so answer whatever you got it, for that answer you have to apply the limit. Okay, so for that also you have to taking the limit. Here also left hand side we are taking the limit, right hand side also we have to taking the limit. So that is, this one we are applying the upper limit first, mean capital F of B plus C minus. Next, we are applying the lower limit. Lower limit mean it is capital F of A plus C. So, it is in bracket. Whenever minus comes, you have to put the term in the bracket, because minus is very danger. Okay. So, that is, here we can take the, we can cancel the plus c and this minus c. Plus c into minus is the minus. Okay. So then it is, this is equal to capital F of B minus capital F of A. Okay. Capital F of B minus capital F of A. So what you are taken here? So finally what you got it? So this is, you got it, integration a to b F of x dx is equal to the, you got it, f of b minus f of a. So this is, we are called as definite integration. This is, we are called as the definite integration. Definite integration definition is this one. Okay. So definite integration is a constant. This is the constant answer. So definite integration is a, we are called as, it is definite integration. Definite integration. Okay. Definite integration. This is, we are called as definite integration. So integration a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Here small f of x, this is capital F of. Okay. So there is here capital F of b minus capital F of a is a purely constant. Okay. So that is, in this definite integration, if integration is, definite integration is denoted by like this, so this value, a value, So we are called as the, it is a lower limit. This is we are called as lower limit. Lower limit. This is we are called as lower limit. And B we are called as upper limit. This is we are called as upper limit. This is we are called as upper limit. Okay. So integration lower limit to upper limit. F of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. That is the answer of the definite integration. Answer of the definite integration is integration a to b f of x dx. Integration a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. So this is the answer of the definite integration. Okay. So here a is called as the lower limit and b we are called as the upper limit. Mean the curve is bounded between the two values a and b. How it is bounded between the a and b? I will show it. If the function is defined on the closed interval a b, so then it will be I will show it. It is how it is the lower limit. It is bounded between the a and b. Okay, so that is I will show it on the one graph. I will show. Okay, so I will show how it is bounded between the a and b. See, the curve is, if the function is defined f of x, y is equal to f of x, defined on the closed interval a b, so then it will be bounded between the two values and it will be represent y is equal to f of x curve. So y is equal to f of x curve when it forming the some area with the x axis and the two values x equal to a, x equal to b. So then integration a to b f of x denotes the algebraic sum of the areas. It denotes the algebraic sum of the areas bounded by the curve. Now see, it is, if you are taking the, that is, I am taking one curve. It is the x axis. Okay. Now if you take the, it is the origin and this is the curve y is equal to f of x. This is the curve is y is equal to f of x. Okay, so and this is x axis, mean let it is the one line x is equal to a and this is the another line x is equal to b. Okay, so this is a integration a to b. Integration a to b represent the area of the curve bounded by x axis and the lines x is equal to a and x equal to b. Okay, so there is a integration a to b. So integration a to b also denotes the sum of the areas. Integration a to b also denotes the sum of the areas, algebraic areas. Okay, integration a to b also denotes the algebraic sum of the areas. So how it is, see, this is a y is equal to f of x curve, y is equal to f of x curve. And this is the x-axis. This is the x-axis, mean there is, that is the, it is the x values or the x limits are the bounded between the x is equal to a to b. Mean it is a between lies between a and b. So mean x is lies between the a and b. So then the function, so this is y is equal to f of x. It is making the this area. Okay, this area. It represents the this area. It is bounded, this is bounded by, so this area is bounded by, this area is bounded by x axis and the lines x is equal to a and the lines x is equal to b. So this is integration, it represents, this area is represented by, this area is represented by integration a to b f of x dx. Integration a to b f of x dx. Integration a to b f of x dx also denotes the algebraic sum of the areas. So this is x values lies between a and b. So then the function, it y is equal to f of x. Okay, it represent the connected by the x axis and the lines x is equal to a and x equal to b. Okay, so if you are observing, it is how we are showing, it is the algebraic summation. How we are showing it is an algebraic summation. Okay, so algebraic summation of the areas. Okay, now see, I will show the another one diagram. In this diagram, what it clear, that is x values lies between a and b. Okay, and it represent the integration a to b, integration a to b, integration a to b f of x dx represent the area of the curve y is equal to f of x and it is bounded by x axis and the lines x is equal to a and x equal to b. The area of the region bounded by y is equal to f of x and x axis and the lines x is equal to a and x equal to b. So now I will show how it is the represent algebraic sum of the areas. See, I will show it. Okay. It is integration a to b, integration a to b, integration a to b f of x dx. It represents the algebraic sum of the areas. Okay, algebraic sum of the areas bounded by y is equal to f of x and the x axis at the lines x is equal to a and x equal to b. How it is? I will show it. Okay, see, it is suppose one curve is like this. I have taken the one curve, it is like this. Okay, let it is x axis, x axis, this is the line x equal to b, let it is the line x equal to a. Okay, this is origin. Okay, now this is the this up to this, up to this, okay, this part to this, it is the one area. Okay, and next here to here is the another area, and next to here is the one area. Okay, above the x axis, that area is above the x axis, and this is the another area, it is the below the x axis. Okay, and this area is above the x axis. Okay, so what we are taking above the x axis, above the x axis, we are considering that area with plus sign. Okay, so it is the with plus sign. Okay, and this is with minus sign. Okay, and this is with the plus sign, and this is with the minus sign, and this is with the plus sign. Okay, so that is mean above the x axis we are considering as the plus, below the x axis we are considering with minus. Okay, so this this it is bounded between the x equal to a and x equal to b. So this curve is y is equal to f of x. It is bounded between the y is equal to f of x. Y is equal to f of x curve is bounded between a and b. Okay, y is equal to f of x. It is bounded between the a and b. Okay, so that is this curve. It represents the so this the here this total area is represented by. This total area is represented by this integration a to b f of x dx. Okay, so mean we done the partitions. We have done the pairwise partitions. We done the pairwise partitions between a and b. So that pairwise partition, let I am taking this name is c1. Okay, and let this name is c2, and this name is c3, and this name is c4. Okay, so that means one part is, one area is a to x is equal to a, this is the a. Okay, a to c1. Okay, and this is this area is c2 to c3. It is lies between c2 to c3, the range. Okay, so this is the from c2 to c3. Okay, and this is c2 to c4. Okay, and this is c4 to b. So this is the b. Okay, so that means we can split this integration a to b, integration a to b, integration a to b f of x dx. We can split into algebraic sum of the integration a to b f of x dx is equal to the, we can split this algebraic sum of the areas. It is the first limit is, it is a with plus sign, it is a plus sign. So it is a plus sign. Okay, so that is started with a and ended by c1, a to c1, that is A to B we are splitting by C1, C2, C3, C4. Okay, C1 f of x dx, and next area is C2 to C3, mean minus, it is a with minus, so minus of it is a C1 to C2, that function is y is equal to f of x, this is f of x, and next area is with plus sign, it is a plus sign, okay, with the plus sign, so next it will be the C2 to C3, so C2 to C3, okay, the function is f of x dx, and next area is with minus, okay, so that is, it is a C3 to C4, that is f of x dx, and next area with the plus sign, so this is, it is ended by C4 to B f of x dx. Okay, so that means you can express it is integration a to b, integration a to b f of x dx, integration a to b f of x dx, you can express as the sum of the algebraic areas. Okay, algebraic summation of the areas, you can express like this. Okay, so it is started with a and ended by b. Okay, in between this c1, c2, c3, c4 are the partitions, they are making the partitions between the a and b. Okay, so and another thing we can show, we can observe here. Okay, the definite integration value, the definite integration value may be positive, may be negative. Okay, may be positive, may be negative, maybe it is a zero. Okay, definite integration answer, maybe it is a positive or negative, or maybe it is zero. So and the function is here, you can observe the function is that y is equal to f of x, y is equal to f of x, it is continuous function, it is a continuous function. See, you can observe there is no break. Okay, we don't have the break. Okay, we are making the continuation. Okay, means the function is continuous. Okay, the function is continuous on the closed interval AB. So closed interval AB, it is continuous at A and it is continuous at B, and in between A and B, and in between A and B, it is continuous, the function is continuous. Okay, the function is continuous in between A and B, and at A and at B, mean it is a function is f of x is continuous at on A closed interval A and B. Okay, on closed interval A and B. Okay, it is continuous on closed interval A and B. Okay, the function is continuous on closed interval A B. Okay, so then this theorem, this integration A to B, integration A to B f of x dx, integration A to B f of x dx, so this is integration A to B f of x dx. Integration a to b f of x dx, we are called as, this is equal to the capital f of b minus capital f of a, this is we are called as fundamental theorem of, it is the fundamental theorem of calculus, fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, fundamental theorem of calculus, it is a second fundamental theorem. Okay, second fundamental theorem. Okay, second fundamental theorem of calculus, this is we are called as the second fundamental theorem of calculus. Then what should be the first fundamental theorem of calculus, mean integration, indefinite integration, where we observe the indefinite integration is indefinite integration theorem, we are called as the fundamental theorem of first fundamental theorem of calculus. See, so this one is integration a to b f of x dx is equal to the integration a to b f of x dx, so it is a integration we are taking the integration f of x dx is equal to capital f of x plus c is called as first fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, first fundamental theorem of calculus. So this is the first fundamental theorem of calculus, and this is the definite integration theorem is we are called as the second fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, so this is the second fundamental theorem of calculus. This is the first fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay, and in this definite integration, you can observe the one thing is here. In definite integration and integration, in totally definite integration and integration, if you observe the definite integration and integration, one thing is very important here. So that about the variable, so that the variable is, so what is the variable here we can observe? Okay, this is integration a to b, integration a to b, in the integration a to b, in integration a to b, f of x dx is equal to the, here when there is the x, then it is the dx, when there is the y, then it is the dy, when there is the z, then it is the dz, when there is the t, then it is the dt. Mean whatever the variable is here, integration variable, that we are called as integration variable, whatever the variable is here, that variable should be, so this is when there is a mean that whatever the variable is here, so the limits will be in terms of that variable. So there is limit, what it is, suppose x, then it is in terms of x. So this limits are x is equal to a and x equal to b. So this is also we can write as the, this is also equal to the, so it is f of t dt. Mean here whenever you are observing it is the variable t, then that limits are a and b. So that is it is a t is equal to a and t is equal to b. So that means here whenever observing the this variable, that limit should be also in terms of the same variable. Okay, whenever you are observing this variable, the dt or whatever the d differential integration operator whatever is there, so that is in the same variable. Okay, that is in the same variable. So t and t, x and x, t and y, and z like this. Okay, so that is that means what you can observe here, variable is a dummy. Okay, variable is a dummy, it is a dummy. Okay, you can say it is a dummy, variable is a dummy. Variable is not important in the definite integration, variable is not important. Okay, you can change the variable depend on the occasion. Okay, so you can change the variable depend on the substitution. Okay, so that is here variable is not important in the definite integration. Okay, so this is a major property here. Okay, so that is remaining another theorem we can observe. Okay, integration a to b, that is it is composition of the functions. If you are taking integration a to b, f circle g of x into g dash of x dx is equal to the, on the substitution method it will become as the integration, it is f of this one we can write as f of g of x. G of x is the function, then it is the lower limit will become the g of a and upper limit will become the g of b, and this is the f of x dx, you can take it. Okay, so by substitution method we can take it. Okay, so by substitution method we can write it is the f of g of x into g dash of x dx. This is integration a to b. Okay, so this is a function and its derivative, this is the g dash of x. Okay, by making the substitution we will get this one. Okay, so these are the basics and basic concept and the definition of the definite integration. Just go through it. Okay, if you have any doubts, okay, you can express to me. Okay, so and please try to subscribe. Okay, and try to share it, this video. Okay, thank you, take care all of you, bye. Okay.